Hey everybody, it's Chugga-Cut- Whoa! Conroy, welcome back to more Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. In the last episode, we got to- we entered the, Wind Temple, alright? In this episode, we're gonna be continuing through the Wind Temple, though. I hate wizard robes. My intro is distracting me, hitting me with fire like 10 times before I get a hit on them with the fire. But anyway, go ahead and over here and open this treasure chest, and you're going to get, I believe, the dungeon map. I swear to God if I know that off the top of my head. Yes, it is! Hooray, I got 10 more nerdy points. Jeez. So yeah, today hasn't exactly been the best day for me. I don't really know why I'm recording. Maybe I just really want to, I don't know, maybe just get away from it all. I swear, today, We had our washing machine break with my clothes still in it, and you know, it being like mid-cycle. So I tried calling the repairman, and the repairman's like, it's gonna be like another like 2 weeks before I can get out there. And so like I had to try repairing it myself, which I did, but like it took hours. I swear to God, hard to find good help these days. Oh jeez. How did I still get hit by that? These things, P-hats, they die with a fire arrow to the face, as you can imagine. Let's see, can I actually hit that from here? You know what? Launch attacks at the same time! Okay, you know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna, like, Deku leaf my way over there and just hit it easier with the auto-aim, because I'm lame like that. Holy crap! Oh, man! Sorry for the freak out there, though, but jeez. A lot of P-hats in this dungeon. If you don't have your 20 arrows yet, or, I mean, arrows, golden feathers yet, like I don't, it might be a good idea to stock up on them, though, because you can get 100 rupees and a piece of heart from doing that. Go ahead and turn around right here, and you're going to find, here we can bomb right here and get the first teleporter, well, second teleporter pot in this dungeon. Of course, because you're not heavy enough to step on the switch on your own, you gotta put on your iron boots, and then... Gasp! This dungeon just, like, quadrupled in size! Yeah, we're not anywhere near done, even though we've explored pretty much all the rooms that you can see on your map up to this point. And now, Geronimo! Haha, I didn't get hurt. But where you're supposed to go is right over here, and... Okay, 5 areas you can go down. Each place has its own... set of enemies you'll find if you go down it. I believe this one is red shoe jellies. This one is no enemies. This one's floor masters. Right, no, this one's Armos, I believe. The statues down there come to life. I believe this one's floor masters, and I believe this one's green shoe jellies. So if you just want to be a speedrunner and not have to deal with any enemies down here, go ahead and select this one. You're going to see 2 blocks down there, one with a springboard on it, one that's just a block. You're going to want to pull them over to this shaded area on the ground. That's pretty much where you're going to want to go. And going up. And in here you're going to find the first key. But you might notice there's a spot identical to this on the other side, but with no treasure chest. How might you get a treasure chest to appear there, you may ask? Well, you have to go down all 5 of these and defeat all the enemies you get from all 5 of these, though. So, I'm gonna go ahead and cut ahead to doing that. And don't worry, you don't get a frickin' joy pendant for doing this. You get something better. And then you get a treasure chart. That is one of the 2 treasure charts you get in this dungeon. The treasure charts in this dungeon are very easy to get. I mean, they're not, like, off the beaten path or anything. You can quite easily get all the treasure charts in a continuous run. But... Kirby, what are you doing? Okay. My cats are normally being their weird selves. Kirby's just, like, all going through, like, a short, crouched, walking pose because he heard some noise outside. I don't know. Well, he might have heard it in the recording. Maybe there's, like, a serial killer going through our neighborhood. Who knows? If I remember, this room is going to be very annoying. It's this room. It's this room. This is the big one. This room always gives me trouble on every playthrough of the game. It's so... Yeah, you get a Wizzrobe boss. Mid-boss, but still a boss. Summons a regular Wizzrobe and a Dark Nut to fight alongside it. If I remember, you have to hit it with... my voice cracked. Hit it! You have to hit it... Oh, whoa. Did not mean to use my ice arrows. Okay. But surprisingly, that actually worked. Yo. All right. Yeah! Something that I actually didn't do a whole lot last time, which I'd like to talk about now, just because we're going to be fighting gangs of Darknuts. You can, once their head is exposed, you can hit it with a boomerang to stun them for a little while, which is just another level of detail this game rocks at. I hate this mid-boss. They just throw three really annoying enemies at you together. And the thing that sucks is that boss, Wizrobe, can, like, summon more enemies to hit you with. Like, it's summoning these P-hats, but actually that's not too bad. I mean, we can get... doesn't have the feather things around it, so we can't get into the feathers around. No. Give me a gold feather! Don't hit me with a sword! Give me a gold feather! Okay, you know what? Screw it. Screw it. Where is the Wizrobe? There's the Wizrobe. Well, actually, it's not the Wizrobe I want to hit. Of course not. Jeez! I'm getting my butt burned here! Okay, I just want to make it disappear. I don't want to kill the other ones yet, though, because if you kill them, the boss Wizrobe spawns more. Yeah! Suck it. You know what? Give me. Okay, screw it. I swear to God, could this room be any more annoying? You know, die! Suck it. Ow! How did I still get- Oh, the other Wizrobe. What the? Die! Eat it! Crap! Ow! Even after I've won, I still haven't won. There you go. Come here, give me. At least I got a gold feather! You know what? You can burn now. You can burn. And at least I get my hearts back. Knight's Crest, you don't need it, because we already got all the Knight's Crest that we need. You can very easily have 10 Knight's Crests by your first revisit to outset. Well, second revisit, actually. But, anyway. Jeez. That room could not have been more annoying, though. But, for beating them, you get one of the coolest items in any Zelda game, as well as my favorite item description in this game. It is the hookshot! It extends, it retracts, it latches onto things. What a cool invention! Sounds like something Billy Mays would market. If he were still alive, it might be possible. But what you're going to want to do is do this. Go ahead and get out your hookshot and your mega skull hammer. Jeez, megaton hammer. I keep saying Megaton Hammer. I don't know, just maybe because I'm used to playing Ocarina of Time. I really don't know. Oh, well. Going! Nice. Now that we're done there, we have our hookshot. And what we're going to do is basically just hookshot our way up here by grabbing onto these panels. I'll show you how high you need to go, and then I'll show you what you have to do. It'd be kind of boring just to have me going up these things, like, for 2 minutes. Alright. Okay, now after the fourth one you grab onto, you're gonna just want to Deku Leaf your way across here, if Deku Leafing is even a verb. I don't really know what leafing would be. I guess that'd be censoring something with a leaf. But, magic! Magic, magic, magic! Must have magic, so I can cast the magic missile. But in all seriousness, this is going to be the compass right here, so there you go, there's your two dungeon navigation items, and the item that you get. Oddly, you get the compass second after the hookshot. In theory, you could drop down into this platform from high above and get it first, but we're just doing it in the standard order here. Let's go ahead and get our iron boots, and then... what are you kidding me?! You know what? You're giving me a gold feather because I said so. Oh, what? You know what? You caused all this! You're gonna die! Okay, we're back. We are back up to where we were. Thank God. Let's just go ahead and hookshot our way up. Of course, not cutting this well. Actually, We're running a bit low on time here, though, so we're just going to do one last thing, and then we're going to go ahead and take off. So, go ahead and go to the end of this platform up here, pull out your hookshot, and get hit by a stupid freaking pea hat! Die! Jeez, never thought pea hats could be so annoying. Once you hookshot your way up here, you're going to see this giant statue in front of where Makara is. You're going to want to put on your iron boots, use your hookshot to pull it towards you instead of you getting pulled towards it. You have to think. Makara, screw you! I want the treasure! On second thought, I want Makara.